chairman of Obeb Community USA. I came to Nebraska today, particularly Omaha City, to represent Obeb Community in the South Sudanese dialogue that is taking place here in Omaha today. It's a great program organized by Brother Dow, actually David Dow. And this program took place in some many states, including Minnesota. And I came here today to support a program to represent the people of Obeb in this South Sudanese dialogue. My message is to all South Sudanese. We have seen what happened in our country for many years, the destruction of life, properties, that happened in our country due to the civil war. This war is a senseless war, and it must end right now. I'm calling upon our leaders, both in the government and outside the government, to hold hands together and realize the suffering of the people of South Sudan and make peace. The current revitalized peace agreement must be implemented as it is, to bring healing to the people of South Sudan. This peace also is not only between the rebel and the government. It has affected, the war has affected people of South Sudan, including people of Omaha, whom I represent here today. Umbek, as you know, is in the center of South Sudan and has been affected by the civil war of Sudan for many years in many ways. There's a war that was caused by the flow of gun into the city of Umbek, because when the government, the rebel engaged in war in Sudan, there was no weapon controls in the country. The weapons flown into the hands of the civilian in the Umbek, and they start killing themselves. And if peace comes to South Sudan, peace will come to Umbek as well, because there will be no place where the gun will be shooting, another place that are celebrating peace. Government in Sudan has not been paying much attention to the war in Umbek, civil war in Umbek, because they were engaged in particularly, mostly, in the civil war that is that happened between the rebels and the government. And that left Umbek completely neglected. Nobody pay attention to that sub-clan war happening in Umbek. And it had cost many, many lives. People are not farming in Umbek, people are were running away from Umbek, people were dying on a daily basis. But thankfully, in 2016, we went to Umbek and we initiated peace, and we are still working very hard as a community all over the world in the diaspora to promote peace and reconciliation among our people in Umbek. And we need the government to be part of this process. To be part of peace, we need a government to make peace as a priority and agenda in the next upcoming month for the people of South Sudan, and in particular the people of Obeb. We want peace now. There's no another time that is better for peace. It is now, it is this year. And I wish that our leaders listen to their conscience and look back to what they have fought for. I congratulate them for fighting for the liberation of South Sudan, but I commend them now to end war and bring peace in South Sudan. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Peter Omoyok. I'm from Cholo in Upper Nile. I'm here in Diaspora attending the Diaspora Community Dialogue. The reason I support the Diaspora Community Dialogue is that the civil war going on in southern Sudan have really affected our community integration. Our social fabric of our community has deteriorated. And now with the recent peace signed in Sudan, I would like to participate in this dialogue in order to find a way for our people to build the lost social fabric, because there's no way out. We have to solve our problem. there is no problem that cannot be solved. If we are sincere and sit down, all the other problems, the problem of land, if we could just go back to our history in January 1956, nobody was claiming anybody's land. The Dinkas were mining their cattle. The Chinooks were mining their agriculture, fishery. Everybody was prosperous. Our common enemy was by then the Jolaba. We fought with Jolaba, with unity. Thanks goes to John Graham who built that unity until we gained our self-determination. But my message is that let's go back together, solve this civil war. There is no country in the world that has never gone civil war. Even this country we are living in, America, had a very terrible civil war. But after the war, they gave the blacks the civil right, they liberated the blacks, and that's why America is prosperous. We, from Southern Sudan, our population is less. God has given us a lot of resources. If we put our act together and reconcile, I'm sure the resources we have in Southern Sudan, we have timber, we have diamond, we have gold, we have manpower, we have animals. If we put our act together, extract those minerals and underground, put add a value to those minerals, we would be like Doha, like Kuwait, the richest people in the world. So let's unite, forgive ourselves, and go for it.
أنا بشكر يوم بتاعت الليلة اللي هو 4 شهر 5 بقوات بتاعتنا كإخوة وأخوات بتاع جنوب السودان في ولاية بتاعت أمها. أنا جيت من ولاية بتاعت أيوة عشان نجي نحضر المؤتمر. فالمؤتمر بيتكلم عن المصالحة وسط الكلام. صحيح أن إحنا كالمرأة الجنوبية أن إحنا تعبنا إذا كان في جنوب السودان ولا إذا كان في دول برا أن إحنا تعبنا. حاجة لأن إحنا عايزين من رؤساء بتاعتنا من سياسيين بتاعتنا أن إحنا عايزين السلام المستقر. لأنه السنين ده كله حارب 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 احنا ما استفدنا فيه اي حاجه. ايامنا ضاع, ابوهاتنا ذاته ماتوا, واحنا تربينا في الحرب. حتى الان حرب مستمر وما استفدنا منه اي حاجه. فحاجه اللي انا عايز نقول لحكومه بتاعتنا جنوب السودان, يستحيل السلام ده اللي يستحيل من داخل قلوبنا, من داخل كل قلب بتاع زول الصحيح هو صاين في الورقة بتاع السلام ده. لأنه خلاص تعبنا وضيعنا البلد, بلد انتحت ذاته. ما عندنا أجيال الصغار البيجي بانس بصحيح بلد ده, لأنه نحن انتحنا من أيامنا بالحرب. فحاجة لا نحس نقول صحيح كلي نحن نعمل الامبلمنتيشن ده زي ما ناس اتفقوا ناس اتوقعوا فيه. كلي السلام ده يجينا عشان ناخد راحة زي باقي دول التانيين, نشوف الـ development, التنمية اللي احنا بنعمل في بلدنا. لأنه كل جوار بتاع الدول تعبوا مننا, هم استفادوا مننا ذاته في موارد بتاعتنا كتير. فحاجة اللي فيه احنا عايزين سلام كجنوبيين, ان احنا عملنا حاجات لنفوسنا كجنوبيين في كل مجتمعات. كان مجتمع بتاع نوير, كان مجتمع بتاع دينجا, كان مجتمع بتاع باريا, كان مجتمع بتاع شولو, كان مجتمع بتاع شولو, كل مجتمعات تيبو وضعيان مجتمعاتنا. فعلى الأقل احنا ديرنا صغير, احنا عايزين نور في بلدنا كجنوبين. حتى لو بالزراعة البسيط تم الحق بتاعتنا, ما في تنمية بيجي إلا بالزراعة. نور عشان نزرع, أرض بتاعتنا كبير, ما نخلي الناس تانيين يجي يستفيدوا في بعد سلام ده كل دول الجوار استفادوا. عملنا أي حاجة. بس الليلة بكرة بعد بكرة فلان قتل فلان قبيلة فلان قتل قبيلة فلان. على الأقل عايزين نستغير. يعني إحنا حتى برا هنا تعبنا. ما في مستقبل برا. حتى إيال الجابو هنا لما عندهم أي مستقبل. عايزين إيال يرجعوا في البلد عشان نستفيد برضه لتنمية بتاع البلد بتاعنا. دي بكون حاجة لنا بكون كتير للمجتمع بتاعنا بتاع جنوب السودان وللناس الورا في جنوب. صحيح سلام ذيك اللي يعمل نفسه عشان نستقر كجنوبين. فأنا ما عندي كلام كتير. ده بكون حاجة لازم نقول يعني أتليس كل ربنا يخش في قلوبنا كسياسيين كرؤساء. أنا بنسأل كده كل ربنا يخش في قلوبنا يدينا سلام الحقيقي عشان نستقر في جنوب السودان. فشكرا.
My name is Reverend Francis Jawiloma Junction. I'm a Catholic clergy who has been living in diaspora for almost 19 years now. I came from the state of Iowa, which is bordering the state of Nebraska, about 2 hours. And I came here with the convictions that peace must be realized by all the Southern Sudanese people. Peace is not the words just we can speak, but peace means that we put it in actions. And I recognize here the actions of the His Holiness Pope Francis with what he did about 3 weeks ago with our leaders in Vatican City, where he put his own faith as the leaders of over 2 billion Catholic over the world, when he put those actions by kissing the feet of our Southern Sudanese leader. That was a teaching in another way, that he was expecting that our leader could learn something from it. And I believe that one of the reasons that the Southern Sudanese people till now do not realize peace is because they themselves do not give themselves a little chance to listen to each other, or listen to one another. Because if we recognize the problem, we must come to the table. And coming to the table does just mean that we can have a little dialogue or a little of exchanging what we feel. I know that some people are still grieving here today, and it is their right. We must grieve so that we can, I don't want to say that to vomiting it out, but at least to release yourself from what you are feeling. And to me, it's not a time of judging, because if we go back to the scriptures, when that woman was brought before Christ, the woman who was accused of committing adultery, Christ did not judge him. He put him before the congregation that brought him there, and he asked them if any one of them think that have never committed any sins. So to me, peace is something that each one of us should work on it from his own local locations. It is not only leaders that all of us keep blaming and saying our leaders are not realizing the peace in the country. I think this has to do with every single individual Southern Sudanese. And in order to do that, we must recognize ourselves. We must recognize ourselves in the aspect of listening to one another, of exercising justice. Because one of the things that the Southern Sudanese has lost is the way we treat each other, the way we look to each other. And as you can see, Mark, on my head. Some of them can judge immediately when they see that Francis belong to a certain community or a certain group in the country where we come from. But we should not look in that way, how we look or how we speak. We must really present Christ in the way we act, in the way we do even single things. And I think the Southern Sudanese in diaspora has contributed very negatively in realizing peace in our country. And I think the time has come. I'm now 52 years old. I was born in the war. It's not good for me after this age that I should continue living in that crisis. It is the time that we need to come together. So one of the reasons who make me to come to drive 2 hours today is because I believe in peace. And I just spoke with my bishop this morning before I come here. And this is the bishop who went to South Sudan, about two times. I've encouraged him and I said, Your Lordship, visit my country if you care about peace. And he visited Juba 2015 when he was heading US Bishop Conference on the Committee on the International Peace and Justice. And he has seen that himself. So this morning after the Mass, around 10 o'clock, I told him, Your Lordship, I'm heading to Omaha. And he said, no, Francis, you were here yesterday till 10 o'clock with the convention of the Knights of Columbus, and you came to the Mass this morning at 8 a.m., and now you're heading to Omaha? I said, yes. Nobody will do this if I don't go. It is a good opportunity that I must come together with my brothers and sisters, that we can be boys who can go out to talk about peace. And he said, report back to me when you come. And I would like to do this in the state of Iowa, in our own diocese here. So I believe in peace. And the peace I believe in is not my own. That's what has been passed to me by the Lord Jesus Christ, that each one of us, all of us, must come as a disciples of peace and disciples of justice, disciples of love to one another. Thank you for this opportunity, and I hope that my brother could benefit.
Hello, yeah, my name is my dad is titled. He is Nuer from South Sudan. My mom was born here in the United States. She's mixed with black and white. As you can see, I identify myself strongly on South Sudan side. And me, I'm 16 years old, by the way. And as a youth, peace to South Sudan growing up, a lot of my uncles passed away from the war. And it was just sad to see that Dinka and Mori and all of the tribes alike split up. I really wish we could come together and build, to other people, we all look like South Sudanese. They can't tell we're like, they can't tell we're Nuer Dinka. And like me, I can't tell. And so, yeah. Peace to young people in general, especially in the United States, it would be like and I think us young people, we need to have more of a voice. Because we are smart and we do know a lot of stuff that also bring peace back.
سينا دانيال شون انا بسلم عليكم كلكم ناس الحين في الدياسبرا وناس في ساو السودان انا بقول لكم انه البرنامج بتاع بيس توك ده واللي هو ذا بيس دايلوج از ريلي يعني حاجه مفيده جدا احنا استفدنا كثير منه فانا بقول لكم انتوا ناس ما جيتوا اليوم يو هنا يا بربير فور ذا نيكست عشان انت تجي وتسمع بعضنا وتشوف حاجات كثيرة حصل والناس مبسوطين وأنا بشجعكم لأنه المؤثر فينا هنا بتأثر هناك في البلد والناس تعبت نقول enough is enough نوقف الشكل بيناتنا ونوقف الفينجر بوينتد وخلينا نوقف برضو كلام إنه مثلاً أنت من قبيلة كده وأنا من قبيلة كده. Let's come together.
My name is Abraham Madurwet. I'm South Sudanese. Live here in United States of America, in Nebraska, state of Nebraska. And originally, I'm from Lake. And I'm happy to be here today to join this peace dialogue. And from the beginning, I would like also to appreciate the United States Institute of Peace, you know, to bring South Sudanese together to dialogue. So we South Sudanese, we are fed up with what is going on in our country. Especially we people in diaspora, we came here, some of our people, they've been here for 20 years, 30 years, and we were thinking after the war, we were expecting, you know, to go back to our country to develop South Sudan. But it turned out in a different way, of which one of us is not interesting to hear about it or to even happy about it, because we need to go back. We need to go back with our children, with our old people, with those who have been educated here in the United States and all over the world. We need to go and develop South Sudan through this dialogue. So for me, personally, I do support this dialogue. Is a key of forgiveness, because we South Sudanese, we have to forgive ourselves. We forgive Arabs because we've been dominated by Arabs from very long time, since the God created Sudan, and then we liberated South Sudan, and now Arabs were killing us, you know, but in the end, we got our independence and we forgive Arabs. So why we don't forgive ourselves with South Sudanese? That is the step we should know. Number two, we are here in the United States, our South Sudanese communities. We should learn from how Americans do things. Even in America, you know, there are some dispute in the government, all the government in the world. There might be some dispute in the parties. But that should make people, you know, different themselves from your brother, your sister. So now we should learn from that. Why we South Sudanese, if you need to become a president or you need any power, why do we fight? Why we don't learn the American system? Why we don't sit on the table and solve our problem on the table rather than fighting each other and killing each other? So I think this something that I would like to pass over to all South Sudanese communities. Please join the dialogues here in the United States and all over the world, and we need to go back to our country.
Once again, I'm Bolakum of Akumdit Studio here in Omaha, Nebraska. To me, South Sudan dialogue is important in a way that it allowed us to have a conversation with each other. The fact that we're not talking to each other made it difficult for us to achieve conversation with regard to peace in the country of South Sudan. We came to Nebraska to join hands with our brothers and sisters of Nuer community and to tell them that we are all victims of a unnecessary political struggle, pretty much. And as South Sudanese, we must be able to seek peace within our heart, forgive each other, and find common purpose. And for that reason, every spokesperson that has spoken here earlier believe that a genuine peace can be achieved once we all come together as South Sudanese. This diaspora dialogue give us a platform where we can be able to sit down together, admit to each other all the wrongdoing that we have done, and forge a way forward to a peaceful solution to our problems. So I would love to encourage all the South Sudanese out there to join this dialogue movement that is now taking place across the United States of America, state by state. And it is not a South Sudan government sponsored dialogue, it is the US government sponsored dialogue. The people of the United States knows that for peace to materialize in South Sudan, diaspora must participate in that peace process. And this is why I, Hasbola Akuma of Akumdit Studio, decided to be part of this growing movement of diaspora dialogue. So we ask our friends, our loved ones, our brothers and sisters of different tribes to be ready. We'll be coming to your state. We'll grieve together, we'll laugh together, and our common purpose is to have an ability to be able to talk to each other, because we are all victims of conflict in our country. We are victims of political struggle in our country, South Sudan, and as a result, we will be able to bridge those little gap of our differences, so that we can be able to have a peaceful South Sudan, where we can once again harmonize ourselves and go back to the all as the vibrant community that love each other. So thank you so much, and may God bless you, and may God bless the people of South Sudan.
My name is Rhonda. My name is Rhonda Lisa Hill. And I'm in Malakal, and I'm in South Sudan. الليلة أنا هنا جيت عشان في موضوع مهم جدا الحاصلة في بلدنا. أنا كمرأة جنوبية عندي دور مهم في التغيير بتاع المجتمع بتاعي، لأنه الحاجات اللي حصلت في بلدي أنا ما مبسوطة كأم كجنوبية، أنا ما مبسوطة. رسالة بتاعتي أولا أنا بشكر الناس اللي قاموا بورشة العمل ده على أساس إنه إحنا نجوا كأخوان مع بعض ونناقشوا الحصل شنو بالضبط، المشكلة وين، وعشان نعالج المشكلة لازم إحنا نتكلم بحاجات جاية من قلوبنا بكل حقائق، ما تكون فيها حاجات بتعطش. زي ما أنا واقفة هنا حسا صوتي براه، ممكن الناس كتار يسمعوه في حتة تانية. رسالة بتاعتي أنا أم، أنا جنوبية، وأنا واحدة من الناس اللي بيكون عندهم صوت في مجتمع بتاعنا في جنوب السودان في أمريكا هنا. يعني أنا جيت عشان أحضر الورشة العمل ده من أجل التغيير. إحنا نجو عشان نسامح بعض، لكن عشان نسامح بعض المطلوب مننا شنو ذاته؟ مطلوب مننا إنه إحنا نفتح ضمائرنا. الحصل حصل، وإحنا ما بنقدر نغيره ولا بنقدر نرجع ورا، أحسن نمشي قدام عشان لبكرة عيالنا وبعد 10 سنة اللي هيحصل شنو؟ بيكون في مجتمع أفضل. وإن شاء الله دم الناس اللي ماتوا الأبرياء دي اللي ما عندهم ذنب ولا أكلوا قروش ولا عندهم حاجة في، يعني ما عندهم personal interest، معلش أنا أقول الكلام ده بالإنجليزي، بس هم دايرين البيزك نيدز بتاع يوم، لكن دايرين ماتوا هم ضحايا. انا بعلى صوتي وبكل تواضع انه الظلم القاعد يحصل في جنوب السودان يقيف. رساله بتاعتي للرئيس، انا ما بخاطبك كدينكاوي، انا بخاطبك كرئيس بتاع ساوث سودانيز، عشان انت رئيس بتاع ساوث سودان لازم في افكار ما كويسه لازم تتغير، وعشان تتغير لازم الناس تتنازل. انت كرئيس الليل الاب في البيت هو اللي بيكون مسؤول، لانه هو العمود الفقري بالنسبه للاسره. لو الاب ما زول قوي البيت ده بقى. الرئيس لازم هو يكون زول قوي، لازم يكون زول متواضع، ما يعاين لقبيله معينه ولا ما يعاين للناس معينين، كده يعاين للناس المساكين الراقدين في الشوارع الكل يوم بنشوفهم في فيسبوك، جنى صغير يده قطع، ده المساكين ما عندهم اي ذنب ولا عندهم اي حاجه خاصه بهم، عشان هم بس قال دارين يعملوا يكونوا رؤساء يوم من الايام، بس دارين يعيشوا حياتهم البسيطه بكل تواضع. فانا بترجع منكم بصوت بتاع امراه جنوبيه انه لازم الحاجات دي تقيف، وعشان نسامع بعض خلينا نفتح ضمائرنا، خلينا نوقف الحاجات النيجاتيف اللي قاعد نكتبها في فيسبوك. فعلا كتار we got hurt from different people، لكن برضو let us forgive and forget and open new page عشان for better future بتاع South Sudan، لأنه حسا إحنا مضطررين كتير. والليلة بوقفتي هنا أنا بشيل صوتي ده لمجتمع بتاعي، وأخويا البهناب والأختي البهناب كل زول يتحمل مسؤولية، لأن كلنا مسؤولين، كلنا مسؤولين. وأي زول في جنوب السودان، جنوب السودان فيها ستة، فيها 64 قبيلة، ال 64 قبيلة ديل كلنا مهمين لبعض. نوير مهم، شلوم مهم، دينكا مهم، إكواتوريا مهم، يعني كأنت قاعد برا جيرانك بكون قبيلة تانية. خلينا إحنا بيد واحد نتكاتف ونكون مجتمع قوي لبكرة. وحاجات هسا عيالنا جرينا برا، زي هسا أنا في أمريكا عيالي يتربوا هنا، هيمشي ينادوا دينكاوي أنكل، هينادوا نويراوية أنتي، ما قاعدين يعرفوا ده النوير أو قتلوا حبوبتي وده دينكا قتلوا جدي. كلنا إحنا مجتمع واحد، ويد الواحدة ما بتصفر، يدين بيكون أقوى، ونوري الناس البعيدين مننا الدور المجاورة كل مرة بيجيبونا قريب، أو شاكله عشان هم مستفيدين من ثرواتنا. في شنو المافي في جنوب السودان؟ خلينا إحنا في أمريكا هنا نبدأ نغير أفكار السيئة، وإحنا نمشي بأفكار السمحة عشان بكرة إحنا نغير بلدنا بأفكار السمحة. قواعد بتاعنا هنا الليلة ده ما قواعد إنه عشان بس دايرين نضيع زمن، في أخواني ساقوا 12-16 ساعة عشان في مشكلة بتاع بلدنا، وعشان في مشكلة بتاع بلدنا ومشكلة مهمة عايزين نحلها، إحنا بنخلي ورانا حاجات كتيرة. أنا حسي محظوظ أنا جيت، لكن أنا لسه عندي أهلي، أنا براي هنا في أمريكا، لكن ما مبسوطة لأن المجتمع حقي اتفككت، ده بقى إنه ده شغال من أجل مجتمع حقته وده شغال من أجل قبيلة حقه. So أنا بترجع رجاء خاص إنه إحنا نسامع بعض الحصل ده. أنا ما داري إنه الزول ده يمشي، لكن نعرف مشكلة بتاعت إنه منو المسؤول من المشاكل اللي حصلت دي كلها في جنوب السودان. كان أنا شخصياً أنا روضة دي، أنا بمد يدي لرئيس، لأنه رئيس هو رئيس، أنا ما بشوفه إنه هو دينكاوي، لكن أنا بشوفه هو رئيس بتاع ساوث السودان، لازم ياخذ مسؤولية ولازم يتنازل من أي حاجة، لأنه الأب الليلة في بيت بيعمل بياخذ مسؤولية تامة لبيته، عشان البيت ده يكون بيت مهم، وعشان يكون بيت قوي، وعشان يكون في يعني يكون في 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 فروت كويسة للمجتمع بتاعنا بكرة. وأنا بجيف هنا ما بكتر كلامي، ممكن أجيف هنا أتكلم ليه بكرة، لكن يا رب إن شاء الله صوتي ده إن شاء الله كان صوت بسيط، صوت المرأة يصل في محل في أقصى حتة بعيدة، عشان احنا بكره نغير مجتمعنا. وانا هنا بجيف وانا بشكر اخوي العمل معاي لبا والناس اللي قاموا بفكره بتاعت انه احنا نجي مع بعض نتكلموا المشكله وين وكيف نحاول نحلها وكيف نحاربها، لانه المشكله دي بجد مشكله كبيره ولازم احنا نقبل انه هاي في مشكله واحنا عايزين نحلها، عشان تاني بعد 5 سنة 6 سنة ما عايزين وضع اللي احنا فيه ده نشيلها تاني مع بعض وتاني يكون نفس البرنامج ويمكن هيكون اسوأ. وانا بترجع صوتي ده، انا بترجع كلنا انا كمرأة ونسوان التانيات اخواتي لازم احنا نخشوا، لانه الشغلة كان حصلت في البلد والمرأة جات داخلة المشكلة دي بتكيف. الليلة صوتنا بقى ما في، سواء انا بعلي صوتي كمرأة جنوبية عشان القاعد يحصل في بلدي انا ببكي، وعشان انا ما دار الدموع ده تكون مستمرة كفاية كفاية كفاية. وشكرا وربنا يبارك.
My name is James Bolchol. Some people call me Bolnyanim. That's my nickname. And the reason why I'm here today, I came to join the dialogue of South Sudanese in USA. This dialogue is so important to us because we are the seed for South Sudan. And if we don't unite it here and we don't come up as educated people, then how are we going to change South Sudan? And we were being promised by Dr. Graham when we were kids that you people will be the one to build South Sudan. And if we go to this line where we divided ourselves now in the US, what will be our goal in the next 5 years? Are we going to divide it ourselves, continue like the way people are doing it in Africa or anywhere? This is something that we cannot deny. You can tell from the Facebook, you can tell from our neighborhood. We don't used to sit like the way we used to sit before the war in South Sudan in 2013. Before that, we used to play together. We used to enjoy tea together, drink together, play together, and you know, visiting one another from state to state. But currently, each community is doing their own activities. That is a division line. And this is why it's so important to someone who came up with this idea, David Dow, calling all of us to join this campaign that South Sudanese, let's came together and let's support what is happening, peace in South Sudan, so that everyone will have a freedom of going back to homeland and support the country and build the country, because the life of that country is in our hand. Currently, with that problem that we are facing in South Sudan, we are the people that has been affected so much. We work so many hours here trying to support people who are in refugee camp, try to support those who are in school by paying their school fees. But if the fees come now, we will be relaxed and all the bills that we are paying for our loved one in Africa, that will reduce, because people will have job and they will build the country. And all of us will have a better job in South Sudan. Each one of us may have an office, but here in the US, only few people that afford to be in the office. Most of us work in a factory. And that's not why we went to school. We want to do something at least whereby your body can relax a little bit. But if we continue with this division that we have today, that is not going to help us. So let's change our mind and follow what is coming up. Let's unite it and work together. Let's support this dialogue. And I appreciated the team that came from Washington, D.C., Bolakum, and then Daniel Atem, and David Dow, plus the rest, and those who came across the state. So I live in Omaha, Nebraska, but this month I'm planning to go to Africa. Currently, I do support people with clothing in Africa. And here in the U.S., why do I have to do that? It's because there are so many people that cannot afford themselves to buy clothes. If they get a dollar, they have to buy food for it, and people went just naked like that. And that filled me, you know, this is my work, I can help. So I need your hand, everyone who is in the house or anywhere that you are in, let's join our hand and support the unity among ourselves. And let's try to talk to our elders who are in South Sudan ruling now, talk to your uncle, your auntie, that we want to change the way the country is now. Let's come to the table and do things in a peaceful way, and that country will benefit everybody, including those who are outside. So thank you so much for this opportunity. Bolaku, I really appreciate it. Mm-hmm.